Everyone is familiar with the law of the land, which in general terms is a country's local law where a person resides. Almost all the rules, regulations, and legal disputes are handled under the law of the land. When someone visits another country, he or she needs to follow the local laws of the state. Now, many of us will wonder which country's law a commercial ship operating in high seas should follow. Is it the local law of the country, which is closest to the vessel when at sea? Should the ship follow the legal framework of the flag state the vessel is assigned to? Or there exists another legal framework for such vessels and rigs which operates away from the land? Let us answer all these questions in this video. A commercial ship, fishing boat, or oil rigs operating at high seas follow the law of the seas in the international waters known as UNCLOS. UNCLOS is an acronym for the United Nations Convention for the Law of the Sea. The convention is also sometimes referred to as the Law of the Sea Convention or the Law of the Sea Treaty. The Law of the Sea came into operation and became effective from 16th November 1982. However, the first time such a proposal was announced before the United Nations was in the year 1973. Over the course of 9 years, with representatives from over 160 countries coming forward, UNCLOS came into existence. The convention contains 320 articles and 9 annexes, which governs all aspects of ocean space, such as delimitation, environmental control, marine scientific research, economic and commercial activities, transfer of technology, and the settlement of disputes relating to ocean matters. The UNCLOS Convention has created 3 new institutions on the international level to ensure smooth commercial, research, and fishing operation without any major disputes. These institutions are the International Tribunal for the Law of the Sea. The tribunal has jurisdiction over any dispute concerning the interpretation or application of the convention and over all matters specifically provided for in any other agreement which confers jurisdiction on the tribunal. The International Seabed Authority. This organization provides the details of the limits of national jurisdiction established in Part 11 for the agreement, organize and control activities in the area, mainly to administer the resources in the seabed and ocean floor and subsoil thereof. The Commission on the Limits of the Continental Shelf. All the state parties need to submit a continental shelf report to this commission showing the continental shelf area has the coast of their country. This commission will handle any dispute in this region. Hence, an X country cannot dump its e-waste or carry out any oil or mineral extraction operation in the area assigned to a Y country under the UNCLOS. Let's take an example to understand it better. If this is a land or a coast of an X country, the coast will have a baseline running throughout the shore, which is mean below water. All the waters behind the baseline are known as internal waters, which are exclusively under the state. No foreign vessels of any type are allowed in this region. Then comes a territorial water, which is 12 nautical miles from the coast. In this region, the coastal state has the right to do resource exploitation, right to fish, etc. No foreign ships allowed in this region unless they come under the right to innocent passage, which basically means they are not here for the exploitation of the resources, transiting arms or weapons, spying, etc. The next is the contiguous zone, which extends from the territorial waterline, that is from 12 nautical miles to 24 nautical miles. In this region, the foreign ships can pass, ensuring they comply with the right to innocent passage. The coastal state has the power to prevent infringement of its customs, fiscal, immigration, or sanitary laws and regulations within the contiguous zone. The coastal state can arrest the ship and punish infringement of the above laws and regulations committed within its territory. Now, the most important zone which is widely used by foreign ships is the exclusive economic zone or EEZ, which also contributes to the economy of the coastal state. Here, the foreign ships are allowed to sail if they are extending to do trade, to lay cables or pipelines, etc., ensuring they are not harming the sea state. The EEZ boundaries extend from 0 to 200 nautical miles from the coastal state baseline. Within its EEZ, a coastal state has sovereign rights for the purpose of exploring, exploiting, conserving and managing natural resources, whether living or non-living, of the seabed and subsoil and the superjacent waters for the economic exploitation, such as the production of energy from the water, currents and wind. From baseline to 350 nautical miles, the continental shelf outer boundary is marked. Hence, the continental shelf is basically between the 200 nautical miles to 350 nautical miles. The law of the sea states that any resources which are attached to the ocean bed will remain the right to resource for the coastal waters. However, resources which are not connected to the seabed in the continental shelf comes under international waters. Post all this, come to the high seas, which refer to all parts of the sea not included in the exclusive economic zone, territorial sea or in the internal waters of a state. Here are some interesting figures about the areas covered under various zones. If you have any questions or suggestions, please drop your comments below and we'll get back to you at the earliest. If you like this video, please subscribe to the Marine Insight channel and press the bell icon to get notified when we post such amazing videos. Please like, comment and share this video and do not forget to subscribe to our channel.